Get disruptive. I'm not gonna lie to you, yeah, men actually have their G-spot in their bum.
Fucking sucks!
Maybe there's trauma that's untouched on.
I used to ride for that boy. I don't like him this season.
Yeah!
So peep this. We've already seen the season and there are spoilers ahead, but we don't care.
Sorry. That part.
Okay, so let's get into it, shall we?
This season of Sex Education has been so much drama.
Controversial to say
the
least.
Yeah, it's actually mad.
I thought it was perfect.
It was perfect.
It was
fabulous. I'm going 9.5.
Let's all write down our best parts.
Okay. Are we ready to reveal?
Let me see yours. Okay, yeah, that was good.
Mine is Jackson getting fingered.
She's doing, you can tell he was at the start, he's like, slow down.
My man's trying to grab eye contact to make himself feel better about
you
the
see
situation.
This part, you see this part, yeah? Look at it.
She just goes, whoop.
I swear down when I saw her put her finger in her mouth, I was like, I know what's coming.
How do you know for what's coming if you can't relate?
It's her smile. It's actually her smile.
She's like, I know I did good. I'm not gonna lie to you, men actually have their G-spot in their bum, so I feel like more men need to be open to this. Do you know what? I have been in that situation with someone before. So my finger made his way up, and then he just went, ooh, and I went, ooh, and then he went, ugh, and then it was great.
Man.
So I feel like men should just try it. Your G-spot's in your bum.
He was like, a whole new world.
I think episode 3, right? Just the queer night out was so beautiful. Eric getting ready with that friendship group. Like, I loved it.
And he's glistening as well.
And I would never put like green and yellow together, but it honestly is giving.
It's good.
Love it. It's like a sexy ninja turtle.
Yeah.
Ooh. And you can just feel that he's been like doing this in his bedroom for years.
Yeah.
And finally he's like out in the world.
Yeah.
Okay, so like Trade from the Church is over there. So Trade is a straight appearing gay man.
What did you call it?
Trade.
Trade.
Yeah.
So, okay. All right. Yeah. Okay.
Straight appearing. New word. Even though I don't like saying that, but yes. Okay. And he's from Eric's church. And
which is just like, objectively really hot.
Yeah, oh my God, fantastic, like beautiful, gorgeous, like the hair,
yes,
the skin.
Stunning, the also, shoulders.
Right.
But the whole like forbiddenness of like, oh wow, we know each other in a particular context and then here we are.
Honestly,
and
like
we're about to have some fun. I'm really, really
And I know that Eric was not expecting that.
My favourite bit was definitely Isaac getting involved in the protest.
Mm, yeah.
That was solid.
It was powerful. It was beautiful.
Everyone was expressing their grievances.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And there were some unusual grievances involved.
And also, did you get the Mean Girls reference?
Let's watch that again.
Yeah.
Roll the clip.
Roll the tape.
If this college can afford sound baths, communal harmony bees.
Save the bees!
They can definitely afford a working lift. And I know that that's not glamorous, but it's really important.
I wish people understood that our problems come from barriers in society, not from our disabilities.
Who is that?
I'm not sure. I've never seen him before.
I don't think he goes here.
I'm just very passionate.
Why is it your favourite then?
What I love it. It's like they all come together. They've all got their different grievances. You've got that little Mean Girls reference.
We love a bit of a noughties movie throwback. And it's just like, It kind of, I think it's a pivotal moment in this whole show where people are like, I am tired, I'm sick and tired of having to like constantly like not be able to have the basics of what I need to be able to make my day go smoothly.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's a much bigger point. Like in Isaac's case, we're talking about the lift, but then you see all these different things of people having their access like not being catered to.
Yeah.
And it kind of like,
And also, there's such a contrast because it's such a liberating school. Like, once they got to the school, they were posed like, oh my God, this is going to be an amazing new experience for you guys. We don't gossip. Mm. We don't do this. You can get everything you need to. You need a sex therapist. We've got it. But do you know what we don't have? A working lift.
Yeah. They've got everything that's like the bells and whistles, but they don't have the basics.
Mm.
Yeah. It's that part that gets me.
So my second one, again, this was kind of like a lead up. I feel like Eric's relationship with religion has been a theme that's been touched upon in every season.
Throughout
but
the
it's
series,
not,
yeah.
not necessarily been like dwelled in on or covered well. And I think this season there's been loads of parts that have touched upon that. And I think the best part of that was when he was about to get baptized. He finally decided he was like, I'm going to get baptized again, and then he this whole spiel. He's like, do you know what? No.
Oh, tissues out. This made me so emotional.
Let's roll the cameras.
Let's have a little look then. Go on.
I have something that I need to say.
Hallelujah. Speak your truth, Eric.
Speak it.
Go on.
Tell it how he is.
I thought God wanted me to be baptized today. And I wanted to make God happy.
No, make you happy.
I wanted to make you all happy. Especially my family. But I can't stay silent any longer. I have to tell my truth, otherwise I will be half a person and I can't live like that. My name is Eric Effiong, and I'm a Christian and a proud gay man. I know a lot of you feel that what I've just said is sinful and that I need to pray for forgiveness, but you're wrong. My heart is torn. Because I'm in a position where I have to either choose to hide my truth and live in pain, or be honest and lose my community.
There's no words for this bit. Like, it's really, it's just so powerful.
But I'm tired of waiting.
Your time is short. Acting so good here as well.
So intense. And
I love myself too much to not tell my truth. So, if you love me, as I am, I will be baptized. But if you don't, then I must leave.
And again, it's not being like, I have to leave. It's like, if you don't accept me, then you are creating a reason why I have to leave.
Right.
This, when she stood up, I was like, I love you, bro.
Yes, mother. Yes, mom.
I love you as you are, my son.
Took her a while.
Took her a while, but she got there.
But she took her a couple of seasons, but she there in the end.
Do you know what, though? She stood up before the sisters as well. Yeah. I was like, word.
I have my answer.
Just even looking at the slight relief on his face when he just saw his mom stand up for him, I think that's just so important.
I think personally, he should have still done it if he wanted to.
But that's the thing, I don't think he wanted to until he felt accepted. That was the whole point, and he didn't want to do it unless he felt the love from his community.
Yeah, he had been self-accepting for a long time, but then you're still bullied throughout four seasons. No, it took to the fourth season for Eric to suddenly be like, okay, now I'm a popular babe, because suddenly people are allowing it.
The thing is, I think, do you know what I think was done well with this? I feel like a lot of people shy away from conversations about religion because of how sensitive and just sticky they can get.
I'm Nigerian as well, obviously, and I just even... just looking at how profound the speech was and even the inclusion, it's just so layered. I think, you know, Nigerians are hyper-religious, so this part of the show was really important because sometimes we're even more Christian than the people that started Christianity. And in a lot of shows and a lot of media, like, when there's queerness involved, it's automatically assumed that the church isn't part of it.
Yeah.
Because we wash our hands clean of it. But of course there's gonna be LGBTQIA people that want to follow their faith, and a lot of times they don't know if they're allowed.
We're gonna move on to the funeral scene because this episode had me crying that the entire way through. Like, start
to finish.
As in, like,
crying or like crying laughter?
Crying.
The funeral scene, crying.
Start to finish.
I was laughing. Yeah.
Are you one of the
genuine laughing? It's a funeral scene.
What are you talking about? Are you one of those people that laughs at funerals?
Yeah, I have to.
After they carry in the coffin, like, and then the woman that was leading it. This whole thing was so sad. The only part that made it light, I was like, okay, they've made it light again, was when the woman came in and was like introducing the funeral, and it's like, oh, please just.
Bro, no,
so
when she was like, what did she say? She was like, Erin Willey.
Let's watch it.
Oh, good. So I wondered who's going to carry the coffin.
See what I mean? It's more sad. It's more funny than sad.
But then, like, you deep how they actually feel, like how emotional Amy is. That's literally me.
Sorry, but the height difference between the two at the front makes the coffin carrying
this
so funny.
I promise you, I was crying my eyes out when it showed the four people doing it, and the fact that Adam was there with Eric as well. Like, Adam's character development.
But why is Adam there though?
Adam's
character development.
It's been
so
crazy.
Happy
with.
It was
insane. I'm so happy
it was
with
good.
It.
It was
Eric's and Adam's character development.
Eric's my favorite character, hands down.
Right, let's move on. Who's next?
The breaking into the pool scene. Has to be my fave.
No, I was cringing so hard.
Yeah, same. I can't lie.
It's so full circle.
I'm
actually drunk.
She's been direct.
And bear in mind,
a woman who knows what she wants.
But this is finally like, remember at the start of the season, he didn't reply to her nudes.
Oh yeah.
So now she's like, I'm getting my own back now, and we're doing the deed.
Yeah.
Allegedly.
Why? It's fine. Stop worrying about anything.
And then all of a sudden he just.
Oh no.
He bottled it.
Yeah, what is this? Oh my
god. Sorry, stop. Sorry, I spent the night with Ruby.
I just had to tell you.
Why did you feel that?
It's when you were in America. We were fighting and.
And then just
like, we slept together and no, as in we didn't have sex. Like nothing happened. We just stayed in the same bed. Sorry.
You know the thing about Otis? He always starts sentences and then he's like, oh no, that's not what I meant.
That sounds really bad.
Yeah, dude, just say the right thing the first time around. Like, take a moment to think about what you're saying.
See, and then she's broken once again. It just breaks my heart. I just love Maeve.
Sex Education, the final season, is now streaming on Netflix.
10 out of 10, would recommend.
10 out of 10.
Go watch it. That part.